Greetings. Hath God said? Genesis 3:1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, Yea, hath God said, You shall not eat of every tree of the garden? This is the first record in Scripture of Satan's strategy against God and against God's word. Has God said? Has God said? Did God really say that? Is that the word of God? There are many ways to say the same thing. Has God said? And to great degree, our faith in God comes from what the word of God says about him. To some degree, we may learn from answered prayer and direct revelation from God's Holy Spirit. John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. But to the greatest degree, our faith in God comes from what the Word of God says about him. Psalm 119:11. Thy word have I hid in mine heart that I might not sin against thee. Psalm 119:105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Romans 10:17. So then faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Luke 4:4. And Jesus answered him, saying, It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Satan continues to this day to say, Has God said? Listen to any Mohammedan for very long, and they must attempt to cast doubt on God's word. Has God said? Tell a Mohammedan exactly what the Torah says about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and they say, Has God said? Tell a Mohammedan about God's eternal promise to Isaac and Israel, and they say, Has God said? Tell them what Prophet David said in the Psalms, and they say, Has God said? Oh, Muslim, this is so tragic. You say you believe the prophets, then you call the prophets liars. Oh, Muslims, you say the Torah and Bible are the word of Allah, then you say they are corrupt. This is a lie for fools to swallow. Nothing more than that. Casting doubt on God's word is just a rewrap of Satan's original try. Has God said? O Muslim, do you want to be a fool by choice? Think about why you behave like Satan. And behaving like Satan is more than drinking alcohol, missing salat, and having sex. Doubting God's word, calling God a liar. These too are behaviors of Satan. I think you want to call yourself Muslim. I think the concept of the word Muslim is obviously appealing. Every time you say, I am Muslim, you hear yourself say, I submit to Allah and Muhammad. Every time you hear someone else say to you, you are Muslim, you hear them say, you submit to Allah and Muhammad. And that is the very real and tragic effectiveness in the deception. Calling you Muslim does not mean you submit to God. It only means you want to claim you do. It only means you see value in the claim. The very name Muslim was coined by the creator of Islam as part of the deception. Or do you foolishly think Satan would form a religion and name the followers fools who submit to Satan? Think about it. O Mohammedan, you need to ask in your heart, why do Islam and Satan share the same opinion of God's word? Why do both Satan and Islam attack the word of God? Why do both Satan and Islam ask, has God said? Why do you bother to claim you are Muslim when you do not know what God said, do not value what God said, do not respect what God said? Read the Injil, Old and New Testament, the Bible. It is the Word of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, O Muslims, you poor deceived people. May God open your ears to the truth. In your heart, you're sincere. You really want to find God, but you're going to have to let go of Muhammad's lies. And may God open your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.